Good morning, my friends. Welcome back to my channel. So glad you made it today. We have two canvases today to review. What is left from huge haul of everyday e-crafts. This, I believe, will be video number 5. So I created 5 videos from the big unboxing that we have with you. If you missed video number 1, 2, 3, 4, please check them out. There's some beautiful product up there. And today, we have in here 2 of Joy Sunday canvases, and they are not very big. Like this one is, let me just open first so we don't have a glare from the light on the canvas itself, so I can show you a picture. I've been cross stitching these days a lot, and I actually making some progress on counted cross stitch as well. Okay, so let me show you picture. Picture is very pretty. This berry, when I was in my 20s, I usually picked them up and we created beautiful tasty juice for the winter time. And look at those 2 birds, love those berries as well. Very easy would be to stitch, because look at this, all the white space you don't stitch, so it's basically very partial stitching, but very clean looking and airy, like it's so bright. I can see those berry will be so shiny and almost like I can see them sparkle and shine because they are so juicy looking berry. And birds in here, very pretty pair of birds. So image itself is 28 by 37 centimeters, which is the whole canvas, I believe. 14 count Ada. And we have just one page. Yeah, that's it. One page on both sides. And we have only in here full stitch. And that's it. No more other stitches in here. So we have how many? 18 colors in here. It's a pretty good amount of colors for such a little, not very colorful picture. 18 colors, looks good. So in stitches it's 117 width and 165 high. All right. And that's the one, the paper that is not shiny. Looks like they start to listen to the cross stitchers and ditch that shiny papers. Well, they still, you will have them because they produce canvases in thousands, right? So, but I can tell that they are probably changing for the better. All right, because I can hear on the internet lots of girls complaining about shiny papers, but it's who like to do, especially those who do in counted cross stitch, those papers are very reflective at night with the artificial light, so it's hard to stitch. So I guess they did the consideration to change the paper a little bit. Image itself printed also really nice as always, nicely stitched all the way around so it doesn't fray. And we need to create in here this little frame which you need to stitch, and all this white part you don't have to stitch. Wow, this will be such a fast project, my lovely cross stitchers. Look at that, there's not much to stitch in here, and there's no like confetti or lots of change of colors. It's pretty much very easy looking canvas, very easy looking canvas. Yeah, 18 colors. Oh, look at how the symbols look here, so beautiful and clean. There's no symbols similar and few in here. Will be very easy to stitch. Very easy to stitch. And obviously we have in here such a little collection of, we have in here 2, yes. Sometimes they have 3 needles, but probably accidentally. 2 needles in here, big eye needles. And look at the threads in here, just like a few at once. Like here is 1, here is 2, 1, here maybe 3. Most of them like 1 or 2 strands. It's so little canvas to work with and few in here. That's it. See how little? You can create this in 1 week for sure. Some of the ladies who like to stitch 1,000 and more stitches per day, oh, you can create this sooner than 1 week. And they create 1,000 stitches uncounted. So can you imagine? On this one, it would be so easy because you don't have to count anything. All right, so this is canvas number one. It's going to be nice and quick with you in here. And this one is a little bit bigger. Everyday Craft, really interesting website, because lots of there's some new product. And to be honest, since my last time when I did my order, I didn't go to the website yet. So you better go and check it out, because they upload new stuff every week, I believe. And I'm sure there's something more very beautiful up there. So first one, like, they kind of like a similarity. I left these images for you to review together, because I can see kind of like a similarity in here, in a frame, a longer frame, but this one is bigger. Here is the birds, here we have butterflies, here is flowers, here is already berry, but also we have some partial in here. And clematis, that's how you call it, or that's in my language would be those flowers. Are they have a butterfly or flowers? Okay, so it doesn't have a name of the flowers, but I think we all know which flowers that is, and they are so beautiful. My neighbors across the street have them by the garage in purple color, and they are like a full bloom covering in the summer. Looks so beautiful. I love these colors, pink and well, two shades of pink, I would say, darker and lighter. Then we have a butterfly, this rustic looking wall on the back, frame, kind of wooded frame that flower sits on it. Really, really love this design. Flowers in here are just so beautiful. I can tell that, you know, it's going to be lots of shades of pink to create all the shading on the flowers. For the centers of the flowers, could be maybe French knots. I would put even some beads up there to extra sparkle a little bit of the centers. So let's see what we have in here actually in stitches. Oh, we have lots of backstitch in here. In full stitch, we have 32 colors, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 colors in backstitch. So no, we don't have any French knots in here. Oh, pattern so beautiful. And also, you see that paper that is not shiny. I wonder, because this is just a one page. Usually when we have the booklet with the many pages, if it's designed very, very big, those ones I didn't see in non-shiny. I think they all shiny paper. Maybe because it's too many pages, and the shiny paper more thick, and I would say will be more longer survive than this thin paper, but definitely to stitch better this one. Anyway, let's see what we have on the inside in here. Look at that palette, looks so nice. Let's see canvas first. This one, of course, much more to stitch. And again, for those who don't like backstitch, that's the image for you. First of all, it's not big because it's partial, and no extra stitches, just a full stitch, because I've received lots of comments to point it out which one doesn't have a backstitch. Just watch my review, because usually in my review, I point it out every single canvas if they have a backstitch or not. And you know what else? I feel like this canvas not as thick. It's kind of, it feels nicer to hold in the hands because it's not so stiff, more like to the soft. Oh, you know why? This one is 11 count. Is it? Oh yeah, it's 11 count. Maybe because did not have in 14 count, so I order in 11. Usually that's what happened. I'm not sure. I have to check my order, but I believe that when I there is up there on a website Joy Sunday category, so you're not gonna miss it because lots of 11 count. It doesn't have a name next to it. Most likely there will be those no brand canvases that I actually upcycle them because I don't like the paper print unaccounted. For the printed 11 count, maybe okay because you can stitch by looking just on a canvas, but counted in no brand, I'm just not gonna order for myself ever unless accidentally happen. But this one canvas nice and soft, so it's a 11 count Ada. Okay, so this is another kind of like a I like to use 11 count Ada for the video whip and chat tutorials because it's easier for you to see and easier for me to stitch on camera without using too much of the magnifying glass, because this is definitely big canvas count 11 that is easier to stitch. And in here looks like very busy canvas, but you know what, it's not horrible, like, because there's no pixelation here. Yes, lots of colors because we're gonna have beautiful flowers on the end. But look, for example, this yellow 25, number 25, you grab one thread and just stitch the stitch till you finish. And definitely this one I would do by the color, so you don't have to check twice what the symbol, what's the thread you need to take it. I would just grab the same color and go. Always you should go after small amount of color because later it's harder to see them between already stitched colors. If it's a single, maybe sometimes couple of stitches, two or three, with the dark threads, it's hard to see the symbol. If it's X, full X, kind of close in a little bit on it. So I would always recommend go for less color first and then go up and up and up, and at the same time your backing will look nicer. See, this is such a saturated canvas colors that is went a little bit on the back, but that's okay, don't worry. All these colors will disappear when you will wash. Now somebody asked me a question. If they can wash with different soap that was in my video, because I was using in my very first video tutorial, I use a green dishwash soap, like a safe for your hands, environmental. But honestly, you can wash your canvas without any soap. Even if you put just in cold water, it just take longer. With the soap, the paint dissolve much faster. And warm water, you can wash that like in 5 minutes, it will be gone. But if you don't have a soap and you worry if that's a soap right or not right, just put in a cold water and it will take longer, but all paint will disappear anyway. So don't worry how you wash, you don't have to follow totally my instruction. It's just I did warm water and that dishwash soap that is green because I wanted to see how that soap is working. And usually with that particular soap, I'm using a mixture for my roses outside to kill the bugs. Okay, let's see, the colors in here look so pretty. Lately I really love to stitch with these colors. This shading for me is very beautiful. And I kind of stitching a little bit right now, some few stitches I have in this kind of maybe similarity in the color. And I really love to work with these colors. It's a very soothing colors in here. Nothing screams very bright, but at the same time, picture will be bright. But that's like a natural, neutral. See, like even a pink, but it's not a flashy pink. It's soft, still soft kind of color. Earthy, I like to call them earthy. And here it is. Look at that. The pink look very bright, but you know, it depends how. Okay, there. When you see like this, that's the color, the way it looks like. It's still kind of muted pink. You just when I take close to the camera, the light over flashing, but you can tell how silky they are. Very smooth to stitch. I love Joy Sunday threads to stitch. They basically don't knot. Sometimes could be with black color and brown, dark brown, could be a little bit tricky and tangle up, but I don't think we have any in here. No, this is gray, this is not black, so we don't have a black color in here at all. Wow, that's a surprise. Okay, so colors in here, beautiful. I love it. I love this palette of the colors. Look at this. So with the stitches in 11 count, we have in here 98 stitches go this way and would be 224 in this way. And also this one partial, but most in here you have to stitch just a few spots here and there, white and here on the bottom, and mostly partial on the top in here. Beautiful. Oh no, this is the top, this is the bottom, so mostly partial on the bottom, sorry, when it's all flashy colors like this, and sometimes I'm looking at a pattern upside down because it's hard to see what is going on in here. Only by the writing on the top you can figure out where is top, where is bottom. Okay, so this is it for today, and this is it for the unboxing of this huge haul with the Everyday eCrafts. Thank you so much for letting me to review your product from your store. I think everything this time that we review was absolutely gorgeous, and I can't even imagine, have to pick from this two which one is my favorite, because they both are beautiful. And you know what, now since we already see two these pictures, I will tell you why I pick exactly this one, because this is partial and lots of partial. Usually I like to stitch in full stitch more than just partial, but in here what I'm thinking, the berry itself, I would beat them. The rest of birds and the branches I would create in cross stitch, but berry itself, to make them with beautiful sparkle beads, what you think, would be that gorgeous? I think so. It would, you know, like those just enough sparkles and not like everything, or that's the kind of canvases that look to turn that good to turn into the beaded stitching. So it's kind of like not too many colors, 18 colors, you can stitch everything in beads. Or if you don't have enough beads in your collection, you can just go to the store and buy just the red shades for the berries and the rest of the threads. So that's kind of like to show you variety what you can do, because unfortunately stores did not bring to us yet good beaded stitches kits, just like a more like a childish, right? And I did request it, I did send to one more store by explaining why we don't want to see all this goofy keychain or this little tiny project that just good for kids. Yeah, but kids not making them, we are, and we want something for ourselves that we can spend hours and hours of stitching, not just like a 5 minutes project. And that's why I told them, I even showed them my sample that I'm stitching, my red and black design that I turn in from cross stitch to full beaded stitch, and I said that this is what we're looking for, not exactly the same design, but I mean that's the kind of canvases that we're looking to have in beaded. So my request will be sent to the factory and see if this time they will do it or not. So I'm trying hard, because I'm receiving lots of requests from you, my friends, to find you a good beaded stitching. But so far, everything, same thing, little tiny project. And I do wait in a little bit of beaded stitching. In the future, we will see a few projects that is not keychain, something different. Still a little project, but it's beaded. So hopefully we will see some more beaded project in everyday crafts. If you listening to this video, if you watching, please, we are really appreciate if you can push company who produce them to create something like this, you know, even little canvases, maybe smaller picture, but in full beads, that would be awesome. All right, now I'm ramble way too much. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you tomorrow in my next episode.